What's up guys, Asian here again with another Build Basics video. This is probably going to be the last one that I'm going to make in this series, just because at this point there's not really much that I can talk about that most people would consider basic or you know, things that you might be able to pick up in a video or two. A lot of things from here on out is basically going to be a lot of testing and kind of explaining things about how rotations work, things like that. So I might make a couple of videos kind of explaining how to build rotations if you guys want to kind of make your own builds, kind of why dots are so powerful in the game. So a little bit more, you know, advanced stuff that, you know, that you guys might find useful when you're making your own build and kind of tweaking your own things for whatever content that you're going to be running, mainly geared obviously towards PvE. So this final video is basically going to be talking about CP point allocation and CP point optimization, specifically the formula that's going on behind the scenes when you're using the Constellations add-on if you're on PC. So this is a post on the official forums. I'll have a link to it down in the description below so you can peruse it at your own leisure. And this is by the famed ESO mathematician Assayer. He no longer plays the game, from what I have been told. You know, it's kind of a shame because he's really been, you know, a huge driver in the theory crafting community, figuring out all the mathematics behind everything. So this was posted about a year ago. So at this point, Morrowind had already been announced, and I believe it is on the PTS at this point. I wasn't part of the Morrowind PTS, so I don't remember exactly when it was, but it was around this time of year, because it was released in June. So I think this was like the second iteration of the Morrowind PTS at this point. And as for some of you guys who weren't here during Homestead, basically pre-Morrowind, they changed the way the champion point system worked. So now they kind of front-loaded the CP, so you get a lot more out of the first 50 points compared to the second 50 points in a particular passive. They introduced Master at Arms, and they readjusted a couple of the passives, you know, what kind of damage they influenced, what kind of damage they mitigated, things like that. So Assayer went ahead and did the math and basically figured out the optimization formula for CPs for DPS. And so this is the post that he made on the official forums describing his findings. Just a little bit of background, too, behind these changes. So in Homestead, CP points were fairly evenly distributed, so no matter how many points you put in, there was about an equal number of CPs to get from one percentage point to the next. So, you know, there wasn't a lot of diversity when it came to which points you put your champion points in as a DPS. You kind of basically put them all into the same two or three nodes, just because the other nodes were basically pointless. There was no point in putting them in any other nodes. So the developers made these changes in order to, and this is a quote, improve the balance and diversity of champion point picks, while also raising the power floor so that those with champion points will be more effective. Basically kind of raising those with lower champion points so that way they're a little bit more effective in PvE and PvP content. And that's kind of why they front-loaded all of the champion points. So here are the two formulas that Assayer figured out. So this first one here is from Homestead patch. And this was back when they had different, basically the passives affected different things. Now this one underneath is the new optimization formula. So this is an optimization formula that he created basically using what's called a genetic algorithm. For those of you guys who aren't big into computer science or, you know, statistics, a genetic algorithm is basically any sort of mathematical formula typically done, you know, using a supercomputer or a high performance cluster. That basically tries to optimize a specific equation. So in this example, it would be F. You want to make F as large as possible, and basically does that by kind of playing around with the different variables, using basically kind of principles based off of biology and genetics. So basically biology, you know, evolution has always strived to basically, you know, it's this very, very basic explanation of evolution, but, you know, it tries to make the best thing possible given the circumstances, you know, an organism lives in. And so that's kind of the basis behind genetic algorithms, hence why it's used the term genetic, genetics being the kind of driving force behind evolution. So there's a lot of theory behind genetic algorithms, and I'm not a very big computer science person, so I'm not exactly sure behind the theory and all the details, but this is pretty much like pretty high level. Assayer, from what I remember, does have think a degree in either engineering or mathematics or something like that. So he is pretty high up there, pretty advanced when it comes to knowing this sort of CS theory. So basically, this entire equation in Constellations tries to optimize this f, which so basically wants to make f as large as possible. And it does this, like I said, by playing around with the various values that can be changed, basically your champion point passives, until it reaches a maximum for f. And so this entire equation is ratios times 1 plus crit chance times crit modifier plus Elfborn times 1 minus the resistance minus flat penetration minus spell erosion divided by 50,000. This is basically 1 minus mitigation. So the ratios is this very long thing. So there's a lot of abbreviations here. So we'll go over each one in detail first and then go over the entire thing. So DD stands for direct damage ratio. So it is a ratio of how much damage you've dealt. It comes from direct damage sources. So things like force pulse, surprise attack, that's kind of direct damage. It deals all of its damage in one hit. And so as a ratio, it's going to be between 0 and 1. Dot is damage over time ratio. The exact same thing, just with damage over time ability, so Liquid Lightning, Block 8, Endless Hail, instead of direct damage abilities. Then you have what's called DD dot, is what I'm going to call it. It's still a ratio, so it's still between 0 and 1, of skills that have both direct damage and damage over time. So there are some abilities in the game that have both a direct damage component and a damage over time component. A good example of this would be Destructive Clench. That first hit is a direct damage, and then there's damage over time component afterwards. Poison Injection is another example of a skill that has both direct damage and damage over time components behind it. S is your staff ratio. So this is kind of based around Magicka DPS, but S for staff ratio, you can also think of this as weapon ratio, so your bow attacks, your dual wield attacks, or your two-hander attacks. And again, this is a ratio between 0 and 1 of the percentage of damage that comes from your light and heavy attacks. Then you have EE, which is Elemental Expert. So they changed the way how Elemental Expert works. So this basically boosts pretty much magic, flame, shock, and frost damage. The stamina equivalent would be Mighty, which boosts physical, disease, and poison damage. Then you have MAA, Master at Arms. This increases your direct damage by a specific percentage. Thaumaturge, which increases your damage over time by a specific percentage. SE, which is Staff Expert, the stamina equivalent would be Physical Weapons Expert. This boosts the damage done by your light and heavy attacks from your staves, your two-hander, your dual wield, your bow abilities. And Done is Damage Done, so this is the amount of damage that you have dealt. So that's kind of why when you look at constellations, there is a specific window for how much damage you dealt, because the amount of damage you deal does change these ratios a little bit. So your optimization for a 3 million dummy parse is going to be different from your optimization for a 6 million dummy parse or a raid boss that has, maybe 60,000 health or something like that, or 60 million health. So basically, in a nutshell, what this does is it takes the ratio of damage from a specific source. So if you take a look here, let's look at the direct damage ratio, and it multiplies that by 1 plus the Elemental Expert, or Mighty if you're stamina, plus your Master at Arms, plus the damage done. Now, Elemental Expert and Master at Arms, because these are percentages, these are basically going to be 0 point whatever percentage. That's basically how you would convert it over. So if you had, for example, 10% into Elemental Expert and you had 12% into Master at Arms, you would have 1 plus 0.1 plus 0.12 plus however much damage you've dealt. And so this entire ratio is basically repeated for the direct damage, your damage over time, your light and heavy attacks, and then your damage over time, direct damage and damage over time abilities here. And so this entire ratio is then multiplied by basically your crit modifiers, and that's multiplied by your mitigation percentage. And so basically what this entire algorithm does behind the scenes in Constellations is it plays around with Elemental Expert, Master at Arms, Thaumaturge, Elfborn, and Spell Erosion until it finds a maximum F value. So if you guys ever took a look at your your chat window after you used Constellations, you'll notice that there's a couple of words, you know, a couple of lines there that basically are basically saying, you know, this is the maximum F value, this is the new F value, and if you hit calculate on constellations, you'll see that you have an old F value, which is calculated based on your current CP setup, and your new F value, which is based on the genetic algorithm, what it found to be the most optimal CP distribution for your particular parse and your ratios. So, you know, the F value there, basically, if it's greater, if it's bigger, the new F value, then it is worth swapping over your CPs. However, there is, you know, kind of trade-off you have to make at some point. Because the F increases by usually by a factor of like anywhere between 0.1 to you know 0.001, and for some people, you know, they have different cutoffs as to when you want to switch your CPs around, because each different build has a different ratio, different damage ratios, and thus a different F ratio, or an F factor, I should say. So, you know, as a sorcerer, magicka sorcerer, you might have a different F factor and a different CP distribution for your pet build versus a non-pet build. And so, you know, you kind of have to make a little bit of a judgment call, which do you want to change your CPs to optimize for your non-pet build and keep it, you know, keep your non-pet CPs when you have a pet build out, or do you want to, you know, spend the 3,000 gold every time to kind of change your CPs whenever you swap back and forth? That's something for you to decide. And, you know, that's all based on how much your F factor increases when you use constellations. And so, what Alsayer did in addition to this is he also figured out the basically the relative performance based on your champion points. So how many champions you have, you know, how much more DPS are you going to get from a relative scale, looking at, you know, compared to a another CP level. And so what he did was he basically made, you don't want to look at this graph, this is from Homestead. You want to take a look at this graph here, this is from Morrowind and Beyond. So basically, he took three different scenarios. He had irrelevant CP distributions, which he describes as putting it in stats that have no effect on damage. He had even CP distribution, which is when you evenly distribute the champion points across all of your different damage nodes. And then optimized CP distribution, which is using constellations and using the output that it gives you. And so what he found was that your DPS, relative DPS, I should say, increases fairly linearly. So, you know, even though they did front load the CPs, you know, at a low, if it was true, you would see sort of a tapering off. You'd see a sort of plateau effect as you get more and more CP, but you don't really see this. You see more of a linear function here. You know, the regression that he found basically doesn't have any sort of squared values, doesn't have any sort of square root, no logarithm values, it's just an x value. And we can see here that the r squared, the measure of fit to a straight line, is 0.99393, which is very, very close to 1, which is a perfect fit. That's kind of what he found out here, that, you know, it's pretty much going to be a linear increase to your DPS from a relative standpoint as you increase your CPs. So this graph is still relevant today. The cap now is 720, so at a certain point, you're going to have to make a new graph. It's pretty easy. You just put down, you know, the next CP point here and just make another point for your ability metric. And so I will, again, have a link to this down in the description below, but what you want to do if you're interested in knowing how much more DPS you'd pull if you were to get additional CP, is you basically take the percentage difference between the two ability metrics. So let's say you're at CP 300, which is this point here. You basically put in 300 here, and you would get out some value of Y. And then let's say you want to compare it when you're at max CP, so 720. You put 720 here, you get another value of Y, which is obviously going to be bigger. What you do then is you take that bigger value of Y, subtract the smaller value of Y from it, divide by that smaller value of Y, and that'll give you the percentage increase that you will see when you are a max at max CP compared to 300 CP. So, you know, if that gives you, let's say, 0.30, then you'll increase your DPS by 30% just by following a optimized CP distribution or an even CP distribution, depending on which equation you're using here. The black one is optimized, the red one is even. And so let's say you're pulling 20k DPS when you're at 300 CP. A 30% increase from 20k would be about 26k. So when you're at max CP, if you're pulling 20k and assuming nothing else changes, so you know your rotation doesn't change, basically everything remains static, then you will see an increase of 6k DPS. So you know, obviously, if your DPS is higher, if you're pulling 30k at 300 CP, you know, and you see a 30% increase to 720, you know, you'll be pulling 39k at 720 CP. So that's basically more or less how it all works out. So the higher DPS you're able to pull, the higher of an increase you'll see as you gain more and more CP. So lower DPS will see less of an increase, relatively speaking, compared to those with higher DPS. And that's kind of the conclusion that Asier came to, which kind of contradicts a little bit the goal behind changing the CP point system. So that was kind of a criticism that he made. So that's pretty much the entirety behind optimization of CP, kind of what's going on behind the scenes there. It is a little bit beyond my head, personally. Like I said, I'm not a computer science person. I have no idea how the genetic algorithm even works. I just use it because it's proven to be, you know, to be accurate. So hopefully you guys found this video informative, and I will see you guys in the next dungeon.